In this tutorial, I'm going to discuss about what is JTAG. Actually, one of my subscriber requested me to do video on JTAG, so I'm giving brief introduction about JTAG. If you need more information, you need to click on my one of the website I have given in my description. Could you please check that description and open that website? There is a lot of information about JTAG. So here I am showing one image, right? It has a bus cable. We can connect this bus cable with JTAG. JTAG has a dongle and adapter also. Adapter has 12 volts of output. So we need to connect that adapter with JTAG. Then we have a JTAG dongle. A JTAG dongle will do all the operation. Then from the JTAG dongle, we need to connect the bus cable with the required CPU or required processor controller. Processor controller, we have a development board, right? So the development board, we have a slot. We need to connect that bus cable with that slot. Then only we can get the proper connection between this JTAG and dongle. If after connecting all these things, we need to flash the software images. So all of the companies mostly using this JTAG for flashing the memory, means flashing the software images to the processor or controller. So here nowadays ARM and ARM EA series controllers all have the JTAG support. So if it can, we can load the memory in all the internal registers, and we can flash the software image into processor and controller, and we can debug the registers also while loading the build. We can see while loading the software, we can see what are the values inside the registers, and what are the values containing, and what are the values occupying that registers. So we can do runtime debugging. So here we can use the JTAG, and one of the advantage of this JTAG is we can do the circuit debugging. We can check the circuit connection, is it proper or not. So that is happened by this JTAG. So here I am showing, right, this is a PCB. On that PCB we have CPU and FPGA. This is a normal PCB, it has only two CPU and FPGA only. But consider if you have a one PCB with a number of ICs, and we have a bulk more than 1000 or 10,000 or infinity PCBs. Those are all have infinity number of ICs on that PCBs. Is it possible to do the circuit debugging? It is not possible, right? We can't say that PCBs are working or not even without testing that PCBs. So we need to do testing on that PCBs. For the testing, we can't do it manually. We need the help from the JTAG. So if we use this JTAG, if we connect this JTAG, it can say that circuit is working or not, and it will take care of all the pins, take the control of all the CPU and these IC's pins, and it will divide that pins as the output pins and input pins. It will give some voltage to that pins, and it can tell us that PCB is working or not, these paths are properly or not. It can tell to us. So we can take the help from JTAG, and we can debug that circuit. So the initial days, this JTAG used for the circuit debugging only. After it has implemented to this memory debugging and runtime memory debugging and memory flashing. So I told you already, in nowadays all the ARM processor and ARM control has this JTAG support. So here we can see these are the TDI, TDO, TMS, TCK. These are the signals from the JTAG. These are the pins, we call it in JTAG. So we need to connect TMS and TCK first, and then only after that this is a bus connection, right? Here we have CPU, FPGA, like we need to connect TMS and TCK. This is a bus connection. After connecting this, we need to connect other pins also, TDI and TDO. Here we can see this is a chain connection, so we can call it a JTAG chain. So in this JTAG chain, if we connect this this JTAG take the control from all the chip, all the pins, ICs and FPGA we have connected in the printed circuit board, right? So in that printed circuit board, all the pins under control of this JTAG. So JTAG divide these pins, so input pins and output pins, then it will send the some voltage to that pins, and it can check this PCB is working properly or not, all the connections are proper or not. This is my brief introduction about JTAG. If you like this video, please do subscribe, please do share with your friends.